It's Game Boy World, and you have sunk my battleship. So here's a new one, a Game Boy release based on a classic board game, but not a traditional Japanese game, whose nature would doom it to never making its way overseas. Or so it seems, but is that really the case here? Mindscape's Battleship would seem a cut-and-dried case of a licensed board game property being converted, and quite nicely, to Game Boy format. I mean, as soon as you realize how the link cable works, allowing two people to play together while looking at separate screens, the idea of a Battleship conversion becomes a total no-brainer. The original tabletop game was basically a primitive analog precursor to the two-screen head-to-head nature of Game Boy linking. Two players sit in front of unfolding pegboards, whose upper halves obscure each player's portion of the board from the other person's sight. Each pegboard comprises a 10x10 grid that resembles a tactical ocean map, and each player places several boats of differing size, from tiny frigates to massive carriers, wherever they like on their own grid. Play alternates as players launch artillery attacks by calling out a grid coordinate, scoring a hit on an enemy vessel if any portion of an enemy ship happens to occupy that portion of the grid. Once all coordinates occupied by a single ship have been called, that boat sinks. Once either player's entire fleet has been destroyed, the game ends. On its surface, Battleship is an exercise in luck. A game begins with players calling out blind coordinates and hoping for the best. Once that first hit is made, though, it becomes more strategic as you try and target the correct adjacent squares to take down that vessel. A big part of the game lies in learning an opponent's quirks, how they strategize, how they behave, and how they deploy their fleet. These things remain in effect for Battleship for Game Boy. As much as any game released to this point in the system's life, Battleship demands the use of the link cable, if for no other reason that other players, unlike the computer, don't leave you with a sneaking suspicion that they're completely cheating. But the question is, did Battleship for Game Boy really begin life as Battleship? Despite the way the cartridge obviously adapts the classic tabletop game into digital form, it actually saw release in Japan under the title Navy Blue nearly 3 years before coming to the West under the name Battleship. While it's possible the developer and Japanese publisher Yuse Corporation had aspired to release the game as Battleship all along, a far more likely scenario presents itself. It doesn't seem unreasonable to speculate that Yuse simply created a Battleship-like game on its own, and when Western publisher Mindscape picked up the Battleship license from Milton Bradley, they happened across this, a game that offered a ready-made conversion. So in this scenario, they bought the rights to Navy Blue, changed the title screen, tweaked the game flow somewhat, and voila! Milton Bradley's tabletop warfare game in the palm of your hands, with very little heavy lifting necessary on Mindscape's part. Rather, it seems most of Mindscape's efforts went toward creating a Game Gear version of Yuse's game. Unfortunately, this amounts to little more than speculation on my part. There's very little information about Yuse Corporation in either the English or Japanese corners of the internet that I can find. The company produced a small number of Japan-only releases during the early 90s, and supposedly ported the original Strider to PlayStation as part of Capcom's Strider 2 home release. But besides that, all I can seem to find about Yuse is that they eventually changed their name to Zeus, that's Yuse with an X, and currently specialize in pornographic visual novels. Mindscape, of course, got its start as an education software company before branching out to license more entertainment-oriented properties like Indiana Jones and board games like Battleship. The company was fairly prolific on NES, but supported other platforms as well, hence the Game Gear conversion of Navy Blue or Battleship. But Mindscape no longer exists either, having been absorbed into the Learning Company and presumably scattered to the four winds after TLC's acquisition, along with the likes of Broderbund. So how could Yuse get away with ripping off Battleship so brazenly, you might wonder? Well, similar to Monopoly, the game trademarked as Battleship is simply a codified version of a much older concept that had been popular in numerous informal variants around the world, including Russia and Japan. Battleship precursors date back to World War I and even earlier, and in fact many of the mechanics in Navy Blue seem to draw on those older versions, such as Salvo Battleship and Ship Attack. Navy Blue Battleship differs from Tabletop Battleship in some significant ways. For starters, its ocean grid spans an 8x8 area rather than 10x10, making for a more tightly packed fleet and a faster game. As well, this renders the larger ships much more likely to take a hit early on. Your fleet grows in size and capabilities the further into the game you play, too. Navy Blue begins with a match consisting of just three ships, one of which is a 1x1 submarine that doesn't even exist in the classic tabletop game. The further you venture into the 45-mission single-player campaign, the more ships enter the mix. By game's end, you're commanding a fleet that even includes a huge 4x2 aircraft carrier. The upshot of this is that each ship type features its own unique set of limited-use powers. For example, your larger ships can launch devastating missiles, while subs enable a sonar feature. Once you bring the massive flagship into the mix, you have the ability to ping the enemy fleet with radar, scout around with skyplanes, and launch missile salvos that can cover a huge swath of the ocean. And while it's wise to conserve your abilities rather than squander your strongest missiles on empty ocean, you can't be too cautious. As the enemy sinks elements of your fleet, you lose the capabilities of the ships that have been destroyed. It's a much more elaborate competition than classic Battleship, but at the same time, it feels pleasantly true to the original game. Assuming Mindscape picked this one up after the fact rather than simply commissioning it and sitting on it for 3 years, which seems unlikely given that a Japan-only sequel called Navy Blue 90 appeared in the interim, you can understand why they'd adopt this creation as a shortcut for realizing their license. Battleship isn't perfect by any means. Every action you take plays out with an animation, and there's no way to skip these. After a while, they become terribly drawn out. And I'd call the single-player mode a joke, but it's actually not that funny the way the AI has an uncanny ability to find your ships immediately, while almost always, somehow, managing to place its ships where you're not attacking or searching. Perhaps it's truly random in nature, but the computer seems to have uncanny good luck. But as head-to-head experiences go, this was arguably the best creation yet on Game Boy. A great conversion, or is that a ripoff, of a classic tabletop game made even more compelling by the options and convenience afforded by video games. For more digital renditions of family game night favorites, keep reading GameBoyWorld.com.
J7.
A hit. You have sunk my battleship.
Excellent!